Fallout 3 Strategy Guide, my Rebel Link for Mr. Ink's walkthrough. And as you can see, we're outside the museum area here, hanging out with Sharon. And we're here for a reason, because the first weapon we're going to go get is the Lincoln rifle. So it's a really good weapon, and it's really easy to get, so that's why we're going to get it. Now, before we go do all that, I want you to write this website address down. That one right there. And the reason we're writing it down is because we're actually going to go to it. The reason we're going to go to it is because it is the all-in-one, one-stop shop place to go to for all your questions, answers for Fallout 3. Fallout 3 Universe Wasteland. So let me show it to you guys real quick. So let's go to it. Alright, so here it is. It's really, really, really good website, and it pretty much will answer any question that you have, concern you have, thing you want to go get. It'll tell you where it is, how to get it, who's involved in getting it, what's the story about, you know, why that thing is there. It has a full walkthrough, and as you can see, it has achievements, places, maps, a full map of detail of every place in the wasteland. And you see under items we have weapons, armor, drugs, bobbleheads, everything, pretty much everything you need. So let me show you weapons. This is really neat. So here is going to have the column explanations, damage, hit, shot, and you know, kind of give you the let you know what the abbreviation means, kind of like baseball statistics if you're into that. And you can see we're looking at the unarmed, the melee weapons. So if you're into the melee weapons, there's a bunch of cool stuff there. But the one we're going to really want to look at for a little bit at least, small guns and energy weapons. And you can see that what I was just pointing to was damage. And for example, the Blackhawk right there you see is 55 damage. That is really awesome. That's really good. The Lincoln's repeater, which we're going to go get in a second, is 50. And now keep in mind, this is when they're fully repaired and at 100. And look at that. The kneecapper, 75. And that is a really good, accurate, close combat weapon. Rifle. Shotgun. I'll get it right one of these days. Alright, and then here's the alien blaster. That is why we're going to go get that bad boy. Just in case we run into any people we can't handle, or we get swamped by a lot of enemies at once, pull that out, take care of them. Usually one shot, one kills. Now let's take a closer look at Blackhawk. You can see it's a 44 caliber, and it's a unique scoped 44 Magnum. Pretty much every gun in this whole game has a unique weapon association with it. And you just don't find them anywhere. You have to actually go, usually complete a mission to get it, or find it in a special area, and they're usually not easy to get to. Alright, so here, the Blackhawk, you see a critical hit to the head of a Deathclaw will kill it instantly. How awesome is that? And it's going to show you how to get it. You're going to have to do Agatha's Song. And if you don't like reading, shoot, it has videos for you. How freaking awesome is that? And literally anything and everything in here. Like if you're looking for, a specific type of knife, there is a unique knife out there. It will have it, and it'll tell you how to get it. So really good stuff. Terrible shotgun, you can see 80 damage, and that's a really good gun to get. But I tell you what, that mission to get it, it is freaking hard. It has a behemoth monster, or a behemoth supermune, that you have to go get. It's at the Evergreen Mills, and you have to fight a lot of raiders. At least, I'm trying to think, probably close to 30, plus that behemoth. So, yeah, be ready. It's well worth it once you get it, though. And here's a video to go get it. Again, like I said, this is a really awesome website. Make sure to check it out from this point forward, because it's not going to leave you disappointed, I promise. So, also, as you can see here, if we go to, we're going to go to the followers real quick. And these are all the people that can get, come with you. Obviously, we chose Sharon. And it shows you what they are, their statistics, what guns they use, their default melee weapons, where to get them, how to get them. And at the very end of this guide, on the, my last video, I'm gonna tell you folks how to get multiple followers if you want that. So, multiple followers. Man, I can't talk right today. All right, so now that we've seen the website and seen all the wonderful things about it, let's go get the rifle. So you're gonna go through the door and kill that zombie or ghoul, and you really get to see Sharon do some of his magic here in a second. He is just phenomenal. Boom! He's so good. So yeah, do your grinding. Grinding, by definition, is doing just this. Looking for stuff, looting, pocketing, repairing, all that great stuff. Since it's not part of the mission itself, you know, people call it grinding, whatever. Now, check out Sharon. Check him out. He's, like, stealing all my thunder, dude. And look, I can't even hit that guy. I don't even take off half his damage. That's what, that is right. That right there is why we have Sharon with us. Takes care of fools. And he talks shit to them, too. So that's even funnier. So, again, the bottom area is not where you're going to find the Lincoln rifle. But, for obvious reason, you know, clear it out. Because we were still in the early stages of your overall leveling. Shit, man. What the hell's wrong with me? Because at this stage of the game, you're still in the looting mode, collecting mode, getting as much money as you can mode. So this is a great, really great area to come and really just loot everything that's in here. Take it back to Tulip, who's in the same building, and sell it. That way you get some cash money. So you can buy whatever you want. So definitely keep doing that. Now, she will eventually run out of money, but if you wait, or, you know, if you start doing other missions and come back, she'll have money again. So you could, cash in some stuff. And also remember my tip about the ammo. If there's any weapon that you're using that you're not fond of and you don't plan on using again, like, let's say the minigun, for example, let's say you don't like it, well, take the ammo that you get for it, because you'll find a lot of it, because it is pretty valuable, and sell it. And that way you don't have to keep picking up, like, lawnmower parts and stuff like that, you know. You could pick up something that has no weight at all to it and sell it. It's beautiful. Like, right now, I'm at, just turned level 20 and I have, like, $5,000. Mainly because I really don't have anything to spend it on. So, anyways. So this is the end of the first video. See you on the next one.